I hope you all are well. I am Monica, your maths instructor. Today I will tell you a very interesting topic of set theory, that is Venn diagram. So without wasting time, let's start. Venn diagrams are the diagrams that are used to represent all the possible relations of different sets. They are named after the English logician John Venn. These diagrams consist of rectangles and circles. The universal set is represented by rectangle and subsets by circle. We take a simple example. Universal set equals to set of integers. If we let universal set is set of integers and n equals to set of natural numbers, then of course n is subset of U. If we don't know about the subset or set, then you can see my previous video. I will share the link in the description box. Now, universal set is represented by rectangle. It means set of integers. Here, set of integers are represented by rectangle. And set of natural numbers is represented by circle. This is a simple Venn diagram. Now, how can you draw a Venn diagram? To draw a Venn diagram, first the universal set should be known. After this, we draw the other sets. For this, we take an example. If universal set is U equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and two subsets of this universal set are A and B. A equals to 2, 4, 6 and B equals to 1, 3. Then of course, this universal set is represented by rectangle and A and B are represented by circles. See, 2, 4, 6, this is set A and 1, 3, this is set B. 5 and 7 are the other numbers which are also in the universal set. Operations on sets. There are mainly four operations on set. First is union of sets. Second is intersection of sets. Third is difference of sets. And last is complement of sets. We discuss it one by one. First, union of sets. We represented it by A union B. If we take two sets A and B, then we represented it by A union B. The union of a set A and B is the set which consists of all those elements which are either in A or in B, including those which are in both. It means which are common. We represent it by A union B equals to X, where X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Take an example. If A equals to 2, 4, 6, 8, and B equals to 6, 10, 12, then A union B equals to 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. You can see 6 is common in A and B. How can we draw the Venn diagram? See, we take a universal set U and we take a two circles A and B. A equals to 2, 4, 8. And B equals to 6, 10, 12. 6 is common in both. So we draw this circle overlap to each other. Here 6 will be written. So this is a overlapping of the portion. This is overlapping portion. Now some properties of the operations of union. A union B equals to B union A. This is called the commutative law. Union of A union B, union of A and B with the union of C equals to union of B and C with the union of A. This is called associative law. A union empty set equals to A itself. Of course, you can see empty set has no number or no no items, then A union empty set equals to A. A union A equals to it's a A itself. This is called the idempotent law. Universal set union A equals to universal set. This is called law of universal set. These are the five properties which are generally used. You can learn or you can see this. Now, intersection of sets A intersection B. The intersection we represent it by the symbol A intersection B. The intersection of sets A and B is the set of all the elements which are common in A and B. We take an example. Before this, I will tell you how can we represent A intersection B. A intersection B equals to X, where X belongs to A and X belongs to B. Take an example. A equals to 2, 4, 6, 8 and B equals to 6, 10, 12. Then A intersection B equals to 6, which is common in A and B. See this? The overlapping portion is called A intersection B. It has only one element here. Now, some properties of intersection. A intersection B equals to B intersection A. Again, this is called the commutative law. A intersection B intersection C equals to A intersection B intersection C. This is called the associative law. Null set intersection A equals to phi or null set. Universal set intersection A equals to A. You can prove this. A intersection A is called A. This is called idempotent law. Now last, that is most important. A intersection B union C equals to A intersection B union A intersection C. This is called intersection distributes over union. This is called distributive law. We will prove this. See how can this this formula runs. See that A intersection B union C equals to A intersection B union A intersection C. We take an example. If we draw B union C, then we take this three circles A, B and C that are the subsets of this universal set U, then B union C have a portion of these sets. See that? Then A intersection B union C contains only this portion. You can see by the diagram, B union C has the portion of all the sets A, B and C. See that? And A intersection B union C contains only this portion. Now come to the RHS, A intersection B. A intersection B contains this portion and A intersection C contains this portion, then union of this and this set contains this portion, this blue portion. We can see both are equal. So A intersection B union C equals to A intersection B union A intersection C. Now come to the difference of sets. It is represented by A minus B. The difference of the sets A and B is the set of elements which belongs to A but not to the B. Take an example. We write it by A minus B or read as A minus B. Take an example. a equals to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6 and b equals to 2, 8, then a minus b equals to 1, 3, 5, 6. Yani ki, those which belongs to a but not to the b. It means 2 is deleted and 1, 3, 5, 6 will remain. How can we represent it in the Venn diagram? See, Venn diagram may a minus b contains the elements of a which do not belong to the b. It means 2 is common in both a and b, so 2 is not included, 8 is not included, so because 8 is also in b, so a minus b contains only this portion, this colored portion. Complement of set a dash, complement of a set a which is represented by a dash. Let U be the universal set and A be the subset of U. Then complement of A is the set of all the elements of U which are not the elements of A. What does it mean? See, A dash equals to X, where X belongs to U and X doesn't belong to A. यानी कि वो सारे elements जो U को तो belong करते हैं, लेकिन A को belong नहीं करते हैं. Obviously, A dash equals to U minus A. You can learn this formula. This is very important formula. Take an example. U equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and A equals to 2, 3. Then A dash is what? A dash is the elements of U which are not in A. It means 1, 4, 5, 6. Now, thank you so much